Even better magic trick. Is there anything? scriptures. It made me want to bow my head. I remember when the church let out. All things have changed since then. Everything is holy now. It used to be a world out there. Heaven sent a great hand me down. But I don't walk it with a reverend air. Cause everything is holy now. It used to be a world out there. Heaven sent a great hand me down. But I don't walk it with a reverend air. Cause everything is holy now.
Last Sunday we got in the car and we drove to the town you were raised in, your boyhood home. The trees were just turning up on the hill, and this was your valley when you were a kid.
You showed me the railroad that your daddy worked on. So near the old house where your granny lives on.
She's nearing 90 years now with her daughters by her side, who tend the places in the heart where loneliness can hide.
Raised by the women who were stronger than you know, a patchwork quilt of memories only women could have sewn. The threads were stitched by family hands, protected from the moth by your mother and her mother, the weavers of your cloth.
Your grandmother owned a gun in 1932. When times are bad just everywhere, she said she used it too.
And the life and times of everyone are traced inside their palms. Her skin may be so weathered, but her grip is still so strong.
And I see your eyes belong to her and to your mama too.
A slice of Virginia sky, the clearest shade of blue. Just the same, they've handed down so much to you besides your Christian name.
And the spoken word won't heal you like the laying on of hands, belonging to the ones who raised you to a man.
Raised by the women who were stronger than you know, patchwork quilt of memories only women could have sewn. The threads were stitched by family hands, protected from the moth by your mother
and her mother,
the weavers of your cloth.
Every
every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong, I'll be satisfied if I play along, but the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me?
Robin in a cherry tree, sing a little song to me. Robin in a cherry tree, sing to me. Riding on the bus, I hear it. Behind the voice of city noises, my father's words are calling to me. Driving, each song he sings, an old companion, my father's voice sustaining all into the night, woven into sleeping, even out of sight, you live in my eyes. And as you critics all betraying, measure true the life you poured into us. You can define the place you are by the way you greet the sun. Weave a net of meaning around everyone. Was it our small town life or your big friendly ways that taught me to expect connections every day? All around you, the faces are smiling. All around you, there's music in the to the world you hoped for, it's in our grasp.
We were marching in the crowds on that humid city day. We were focused on the struggles a world away. And you said the need is present, and sometimes at your door, you know a man deserves to be honored, deserves to be answered. All around you, the faces are smiling. All around you, there's music in the air. All around you, we're striving. Just a few steps closer now hoped for. It's in our grasp, the world you worked for. Let's make it last.
Did you stand there all alone? Oh, I cannot explain what's going down. I can see you standing next to me. In and out, somewhere else right now. You sigh, look away. I can see you clear as day. Close your eyes, so afraid. Behind that baby face, do 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 do. You can drive all night, looking for the answers in the pouring rain. You wanna find peace of mind, looking for the answers.
You can find a reason leftovers saved. Wash the dishes and put them away. And I have told you a story and tucked you in tight at the end of your knockabout day. As the moon sets its sails to carry you to sleep over the midnight sea, I will sing you a song that was sung to me. May it keep you good company. And you can be anybody you want to be. You can love whomever you will. And you can travel any country where your heart leads. You can gather friends around. You can choose one special one. And the only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind when you're gone. There are girls who grow up strong and bold. There are boys quiet and kind. Some race on ahead, some follow behind. Some go in their own way and time. Some women love women, some men love men. Some race children and some never do. And dream all the day, never reaching the end of everything that's possible for you. But don't be rattled by names, by taunts, by games, but seek out spirits true. If you give your the best part of yourself, they will give the same back to you. And you can be anybody you want to be. You can love whomever you will. You can travel any country where your heart leads, and though I will love you still, you can live by yourself, you can gather friends around, you can choose one special one, and the only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind. The only measure of your words and your deeds will be the love you leave behind when you're gone.
Sing when the Spirit says sing. You got gotta sing when the Spirit says sing. When the Spirit says sing, you gotta sing, oh Lord. You gotta sing when the Spirit says sing. Spirit says sing, Spirit says sing. Spirit says sing, Spirit says sing. Spirit says sing, Spirit says sing. You gotta dance when the Spirit says dance. You gotta dance when the Spirit says dance. When the Spirit says dance, you gotta dance, oh Lord. You gotta dance when the Spirit says dance. Spirit says dance. Spirit says dance, Spirit says dance, Spirit says dance, Spirit says dance, Spirit says dance. Spirit says dance. You've gotta laugh when the Spirit says laugh. You've gotta laugh when the Spirit says laugh. When the Spirit says laugh, you gotta laugh, oh Lord. You gotta laugh when the Spirit says laugh. Spirit says laugh. Spirit says love, Spirit says love, Spirit says love, Spirit says love, Spirit says love. You gotta shout when the Spirit says shout. You gotta shout when the Spirit says shout. When the Spirit says shout, you gotta shout, oh Lord. You gotta shout when the Spirit says shout. Spirit says shout. Spirit says shout, Spirit says shout, Spirit says shout, Spirit says shout, Spirit says shout. You gotta do when the Spirit says do. You gotta do when the Spirit says do. When the Spirit says do, you gotta do, oh Lord. You gotta do when the Spirit says do. Spirit says do. Spirit says do, Spirit says do, Spirit says do, Spirit says do, Spirit says do.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Virtual Worship with the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring. I'm Bruce McConaughey, today's worship associate, and my pronouns are he, him, and his. You're joining me today with the sound of Maryland cicadas in the background. This morning, we have the pleasure of marking an important rite of passage. In this bridging Sunday service, we honor those among us who are graduating from high school and mark their transition as they bridge from childhood into adulthood. This is but one of many thresholds they will cross in their lives, and a chance for us all to reflect on the ways we've grown and changed and marked important transitions of our own. Whether this is your first time joining us for virtual worship or your 51st, I'm glad you're here. Ryan Smith is our welcoming captain today and would be glad to answer your questions in the chat. Ryan will also be available during virtual coffee hour after the service. If you're watching live, you can log on to Google to participate in the chat in real time. This is a big part of how we connect with one another during these services. Comments won't be available for later playback, but during the service they are very public, so please keep that in mind. Also, the live chat has some safety features to prevent disruptive comments, so you won't be able to post special characters or complete web addresses. American Sign Language Interpretation is available in a Zoom room for those of you who wish to use it. If you need help finding that link, please ask in the chat or email VSTechSupport@UUCSS.org. In a few minutes, everyone will be invited to light our flaming chalices. So now is a good time to get your chalice, a candle, or even a flashlight, so you can join us in kindling the flame of community. But first, let's take a moment to say thank you to all of those who have made today's service possible. Please join me in the words on your screen as we light our chalices and reaffirm our congregational commitment. May this light warm our hearts with love and caring and guide us in the ways of truth. As we gather here for worship, we pledge ourselves to the endless search for truth, to the right of each to believe as mind, heart, and conscience dictate, to accept the responsibilities this freedom commands, and to implement our belief in the essential worth and dignity of every human being. May it be so. Now let's join together in singing. The words to the song will appear on your screen.
As for me and my house, you will find us serving peace. As for me and my house, you will find us serving peace. As for me and my house, you will find us serving peace. Peace for all right now. As for me and my house, you will find us serving joy. As for me and my house, you will find us serving joy. As for me and my house, you will find us serving joy, joy for all right now. As for me and my house, you will find us serving love. As for me and my house, you will find us serving love. As for me and my house, you will find us serving love, love for all right now. Let there be joy for all right now. Let there be peace for all right now.
Good morning. My name is Rick Engdahl, and my pronouns are he, him, his. This year, I have had the pleasure of serving as a mentor for Noah LeBlanc in the UUCSS Coming of Age program. Coming of age was, of course, a little different this year. Our teens had to meet on Zoom to explore what it means to be a Unitarian Universalist. They learned about our tradition's sources, about the seven principles, and about our new proposed eighth principle. And now, as the year ends, each student is sharing something about themselves, their own personal beliefs, values, or spirituality, in a brief video. Noah's presentation today is the sixth and final credo in the 2021 Coming of Age program. Now, coming of age is significant in the life of a teenager, and you will soon hear Noah's thoughts and insights as he takes this step on life's journey. But coming of age is also an opportunity for the rest of us. an opportunity for us to get to know these young people, not just as someone's kid who's gotten so tall and grown so much. No. It's an opportunity to get to know these complex and interesting inheritors of the world, as individuals, as themselves. And so after today, when you talk to Noah, you'll know more about him. You will know where to start a conversation. And you will be excited to have that conversation because Noah, as you will see, is a really fascinating guy. He may come off as quiet and unassuming, but with that quiet comes incredible creativity. During today's postlude, you will hear one of Noah's musical compositions, and I think you'll want to hear more. In his presentation, you will get a glimpse of Noah's paintings and photographs, and you will want to see more. You'll also learn about some of Noah's ambitions, his works in progress, and you will look forward to seeing those stories unfold. With a quiet confidence, Noah is taking on the world. He's challenging himself, setting goals, creating beauty, and enjoying life. We're glad you've all joined our community today. You're invited to a Zoom breakout room after the service during our virtual coffee hour to recognize Noah's accomplishment. And now, without further ado, here's Noah.
Hi, I'm Noah, and when I first heard about this project, I instantly had an idea. And yes, that's what I look like. I'm blue. In the movies, you see the kid who go out and live in the wilderness for a week. In the books, there's a person who travels the country to find himself. Well, my family's always talked about going backpacking in Great Dance since once I was old enough. So maybe this could be it. This could be like in the movies, and I would go out the vast expanse of the world, and maybe I'll come to some realization about what life is. So I set off on the grand hike of my lifetime. Just kidding. There's COVID out there. My family's always busy, I have to buy all this backpacking stuff, and my sister will probably fall asleep after hiking for 3 minutes. It just couldn't happen, at least not in time for the end of the deadline. So instead, what if I think of my life as the project, rather than the project, the reflection of my life? Maybe my life is the big backpacking adventure and my blue self is on it right now. I can think of my life as a road with lots of stuff along the way. Some stuff bigger than others. One of the stuff that I passed along the way was a mountain, if you will, a challenge. It was a song that you heard earlier during the service. Another hill I climbed or river I swam. I don't know, but my photography, pretty proud of it. And also my paintings. This is a mountain I painted that gets deeper and colder as you go up, harder to climb, basically. It represents Moonlight Sonata, which starts off calm and mellow, but then gets very hard near the end and fast. I'm currently learning how to play it on piano, and it's been a challenge for sure, probably the most challenging thing I've ever done. Someday I may actually get to go backpacking, but for now I'll keep hiking at my own pace through the fields of green and silver and cold and beautiful, and lay and watch the stars on the journey of life. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
It is the practice of this congregation to hold sacred space for sharing joys and sorrows. This is a time to share. This is an important part of our worship together, even though we haven't always done it in the same way. Before the pandemic, when we gathered in person, We often shared verbally from a microphone in the sanctuary. Other times, everyone could write their joys and sorrows down, and a worship leader would share them during the service. During the pandemic, we invite anyone with a joy or sorrow to share it and type it in the chat box while gentle music plays. As we prepare to transition to hybrid worship in the fall, where people will be able to participate both virtually and in person, we will likely try different ways of sharing our joys and sorrows until we find what works best for that setting. But no matter what form our joys and sorrows take, it's important to remember that everything we share will be public during the broadcast. If you're experiencing something difficult in your life and would like some extra support, I encourage you to send an email to layministers@uucss.org, and either they or Reverend Kristen will be in touch. Thankfully, no one needs special training or a special title to offer love and care for others. So please go ahead and grab a notepad or make a note in your preferred app of the people whose joys and sorrows touch your heart and who you'd like to reach out to this week. If you're watching this service later as a recording, I hope you hold your own joys and sorrows as tenderly as you would those of others, and that you will send loving kindness to all of the people in our world and your life who need it. Let us now open our hearts to the joys and sorrows this gathered community has to share.
Thank you. spirit of life filling our lungs, beating in our hearts, always reaching and branching out in, with, and among us. We gather this morning with gratitude for the breadth and depth of life. We give thanks for the blessings of all of the babies born and adopted and welcomed in the last year here in our congregation and to people we each love. For all children and youth wrapping up this unusual school year, and for the learning and growing they've done along the way. For those graduating high school seniors in our lives and all of the hard work it took for them to reach this milestone, and for all their futures hold. For college and university, for new partnerships and marriages, for anniversaries and birthdays, for new jobs and careers, for retirements and even unplanned endings that have made room for new beginnings. For the fullness of all of it, we give thanks. For some of us, these kinds of milestones are deeply significant, while others cross different kinds of thresholds that punctuate their lives. Life doesn't come with a one-size-fits-all guidebook, a fail-safe way to approach every situation, make every choice, navigate every relationship. Our learning doesn't stop when our schooling does, and growing up doesn't end when we earn a particular degree or reach a particular age. We celebrate diplomas and degrees and careers, but we also celebrate the wisdom that comes from experience beyond the formal classroom setting and the important labor not always valued by capitalism. We give thanks for the ways everyone here blazes their own unique trail and for the partners we find here at church to join us for the journey. And so, we give thanks for the gift of being together in this place. Each person's presence here is a blessing, an offering given in the hope that this church will continue to thrive decades from now, transforming the lives of people who covenant here together while they in turn transform the world. Hope that this church will nurture all of us into becoming our best selves, inspire us in the never-ending pursuit of truth, comfort us when we are hurting, and eventually the hope that we will live on in the memories and rituals and service of this church, even after we have made life's ultimate pilgrimage into death. May all who shared joys and celebrations this morning feel those blessings magnified in the hearts of all joining us for the service today. May all whose sorrows have been shared aloud and all whose sorrows run too deep for words know that they are held in a love deep and wide enough for it all. May that big love guide us to live in ways that bear witness to grace and love and mercy. May that big love inspire us to live towards our shared vision, a vision of free selves, a freer community, and a freer world to which our faith is dedicated, the vision for which all those who have come before have labored so long. Amen. Blessed be.
Building bridges between our divisions, I reach out to you, will you reach out to me? With all of our voices and all of our visions, friends, we could make such sweet harmony. Building bridges between our divisions, I reach out to you, will you reach out to me? With all of our voices and all of our visions, friends, we could make such sweet harmony.
Building bridges between
visions. I reach out to bridges. Will you reach out to visions? With reach out to bridges. With reach out to visions. I reach out to visions. Will you reach out to visions? With all of our voices, and all of our visions, I've reached out to the bridges, which reach out to me. With all of our voices, which reach out to our visions, I've reached out to our voices, which reach out to me. With all of our voices and all of our visions, friends, we could make such sweet harmony.
Hello, hello. I'm Jake Ryder, former youth and current YRU advisor, and my pronouns are he, him, and his. I'm here to introduce the Bridging Youth, Peyton, Dahlia, Sophia, and Danielle, and to talk a bit about my own experiences growing up in the very same church as these esteemed individuals. Somehow it's been 10 years since I finished coming of age and joined the ranks of the Young Religious Unitarian Universalists. For me, YRUU was a weird and good time, filled with chalice pyres and movie reviews, pilfered snacks from coffee hour, and easy camaraderie in our fellowship hall. Sometimes it meant working through the night on powerful personal services or equally impressive haunted houses, but mostly it meant hanging out in a little community of our own making. I found my voice speaking in front of the congregation, and I found parts of myself talking with the young and the young at heart, all these people so similar to me and so different from me all at once. A good and weird time. Bridging, in contrast, was a good and weird time. I remember passing between Reverend Liz and Sarah, but can't remember whether it was through a wicker archway or across a metaphorical bridge. I remember my family nearby and watching, Alex proactively offering Mom a much-needed tissue. And I remember wondering if I was supposed to feel different, changed somehow, transformed by this ritual. With high school ending and the threat of college looming on the horizon, bridging felt like one more stepping stone in a big sequence of changes, but so small on its own. Even with all the wise words and kind faces around, it was hard to take this one little moment and feel the multitude of moments, of changes, of growth it was meant to represent. It's still difficult, but it's still so worth it to take a moment to step back from the little changes, year to year, day to day, moment to moment, and to see and celebrate how far you've come. So cheers to that. Cheers to the little moments today, and cheers to all the little moments through the years, and cheers to all the little moments to come. To the youth bridging today, Danielle, Peyton, Dahlia, and Sophia, let me say that we're proud of the smart, compassionate, imaginative, and inspiring people who you've become and who you are. And we're excited with you, and just a little terrified, for whatever is next.
Thank you.
In their meditation on opposites, Alex Capitan reflects, "Spirit of many names and of no name at all, help us find release from our belief that all things must be either or. This belief that walls us off from one another, ensnaring us in a battle of same versus different. Help us to open our minds, to deeply listen, and to truly know one another, finally glimpsing the kaleidoscope beauty of the divine." I remember my first time working with a YRUU group. It was actually just a few years ago in my first UU space as an interim. Our first meeting together was spent laughing, joking, and making plans for the upcoming year. It was a con year, and there was a lot for me to learn about planning a con. But the youth I sat with and communed with that day promised that we'd make it all happen. What I learned in this first YRUU space is that Unitarian Universalist youth who participate in religious education-based faith development grow into deep listeners, young people who care enough about those who interact with them in all phases of community to break down walls of either-or-ness. In the moment, even though I was the adult, this group of young people set my mind at ease. They helped me to understand that they would love and appreciate all effort that I gave them, and in return would take the reins in planning this event that was so important to them. And in the end, we indeed made it all happen. When I came to UUCSS, I carried with me an awe for YRUU, developed by my time with my first YRUU group. And this awe was not interrupted. The first group that officially welcomed me on my first Sunday at UUCSS were youth from YRUU. From the welcome poster made for me by Danielle Levesque, and by the way, this poster is going to travel with me wherever I go, to the youth who bravely greeted me in a whirlwind of activity during that first coffee hour, I knew that this young group of individuals were smart, funny, caring, and kind. But most importantly, I came to understand that this group loved the space that they were carving out for themselves at UUCSS. And as I've gotten to know the youth who have bridged from this phase of childhood faith formation to the very beginnings of adult faith formation that will hopefully carry them through for the rest of their days, I've come to know young adults who are forging their way through moments in time with open minds, loving hearts, and helping hands that care not only for creation, but for one another and their community as well. I am so excited for our future because the youth, our young adults, who reached another milestone in our witness today are strong women who have overcome physical obstacles, have used their voices to advocate for a better and more equitable community, and have captivated us with a meaningful and a brilliant silence. And the young man who took today took steps into faithful adulthood is a kind, caring, and creative soul. All of these youth have continued to shine brightly in a year that has dimmed the light for some and even extinguished light for others. On this day, UUCSS is blessed to be the faith home to the kaleidoscope of beauty that is Dahlia, Danielle, Peyton, and Sophia. And each of these brilliant young souls is a representation of what is divine. Amen. Ashe and peace.
As we prepare for the offering, most of us begin by finding our checkbooks or the giving app on our phones. But this morning, I invite us to begin instead by searching our hearts. Before we even think of money, let us bring to mind all of our gratitude, all of our love, all of our abundance, all of our hope, all the gifts of life, and make our offering out of them. There are three ways you can make your financial gift to the congregation. The first is by downloading the Give Plus mobile app from Vanco to set up an account. The second way is to give by using your phone to text a message to 833-880-1363. And if the app or texting just don't work for you, the third way is by mailing a check directly to the church. All of the information you need for all three of these methods is on your screen now and will appear again toward the end of today's service. I hope you will join me in making an offering with gratitude for all of life's gifts and all that UUCSS means to you. The offering will now be given and received with joy.
Thank you.
May the gifts we have given fuel the flame of our commitment, empower us to serve out our mission, and give the life we share the shape of truth, love, and justice.
Good morning. Thank you for being here today. My name is Colin Riggs, and I am a member of the Board of Trustees of the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring. My pronouns are he, him, and his. Our church is not only the organization that puts together these services. We are a vibrant community of volunteers and staff, a member of the Unitarian Universalist Association, and a part of the global UU domination. Visitors are especially welcome for our virtual coffee hour after the service to learn more about us. Today we have three announcements. Flower Communion. It was good to see those of you who were able to make it on Saturday for the in-person Flower Communion ritual at church. Reverend Kristen is going to incorporate pictures from Saturday into our virtual flower communion service next Sunday, and she would love your pictures of flowers to add to them. So take a few minutes in the next few days to take pictures of any flowers around your home or in your neighborhood or along your walking path and send them to minister@uucss.org by this Wednesday, June 9th. Goodbye, drive-through for Marcia. Please join us in wishing Marcia Thrall a fond farewell on Saturday, June 12th, from 3 to 5 p.m. in the church parking lot. Everyone is invited to make signs or decorate their cars so UUCSS can send Marcia off on her next adventure with our best wishes. Annual Meeting. Next Sunday, after the service, UUCSS will have its annual meeting. The budget for next church year, new members of the Leadership Development Committee, and new board members are all on the agenda. All members who have made a financial contribution in the last 15 months are eligible to vote at this meeting. The final agenda, supporting materials, and Zoom link will be sent to the congregation. The resolution to adopt the eighth principle will also be put before the congregation at our meeting on June 13th. You can find the language of the resolution, responses to frequently asked questions, and information about the meeting process on the UUCSS website. In a moment, we'll hear from Mary Beth Lerner about what the Eighth Principle means to her. After the service, members of the Eighth Principle Task Force will be available in a coffee hour breakout room for anyone who would like to talk more about the Eighth Principle and the UUCSS resolution. We give thanks for all the activities that enrich and enliven our congregational life.
Good morning. My name is Mary Beth Lerner, and I'm a member of the Eighth Principle Task Force. In a recent discussion called A Conversation on Covenant, an Article 2 Study Commission panel, the Reverend Dr. Bill Sinkford, a former president of the UUA, observed, quote, that covenants are formed and reshaped on the denominational level in response to groundswells of opinion, unquote. I think it's safe to say that right now, there is a groundswell of opinion happening in Unitarian Universalism around covenant. It is happening on the national level, as witnessed by the charge to the Article 2 Study Commission by the UUA Board to look at our principles and purposes last revised in 1987 and create a living document that, quote, challenges us to place the liberation of all at the center of our lives, unquote. The charge goes on to say that our commitment to personal, institutional, and cultural change rooted in anti-oppression, anti-racism, and multiculturalism values and practices is love in action. and should be centered in any revision of Article 2. This groundswell is also happening on the denominational level. As of June 1st, there have been 64 adoptions of the Eighth Principle, and many more congregations are slated to vote in just the coming month. The Eighth Principle is aspirational. It can motivate, furnish, and support the transformation we want to see. It points us to the question of how are we to live? How are we to stay in relationship to one another? How are we to treat one another? And says we can become a beloved community. We can become a liberating faith. We can embody love in action. The Eighth Principle is also a call to action and a demand for accountability, which is why it is crucial that the work of anti-racism and oppression be expressed in our foundational language. We live in a deeply flawed society, and while individual commitment and change are important, they are not enough because they don't change fundamental structures of racism and oppression. If we are fundamentally interdependent, if we are indeed a people of love, then we must live in to what Dr. Cornel West means when he says that, quote, justice is what love looks like in public, unquote. So let's talk. Come to the Eighth Principle Coffee Hour after the service. Reach out to members of the Racial Justice Task Force and the Eighth Principle Task Force and members of the board, and let's talk. Let's talk about what we are actually going to do in order to live into the Eighth Principle if we do adopt it. Let's be part of the groundswell. Thank you.
Thank you.
please join me in the words of our chalice extinguishing. Carry the flame of peace and love until we meet again.
Our benediction today is a piece of poetry written by Arlen Goff. I've adapted it a little bit. A piece of poetry is called Thresholds. Thresholds, we cross them every day. From room to room, from outside to inside, and back again. From here to there, from anywhere to everywhere. From age to age, each threshold offers an opportunity for change, for renewal, for transformation. From what we were and what we are to what we can be. In this hour and in this place, we have crossed a threshold from our day-to-day everydayness into space and time attuned to the other, to the sacred, to the holy, into an awareness of new beginnings pregnant with possibilities. How have we been renewed in this moment? How have we been changed by this hour? How will we be transformed through this gathering of beloved community? Bless you, you longing, thirsty souls. May blessings and gratitude spring from our worship together. Our worship has ended, and now our service begins.